Kluger on the steal. Puts it right on goal. Stop battling for it right there. Zucker puck loose. And it just trickles wide of the post.
Well, Colby talked about Zucker getting in front of the net. There he is again in front of Bronte. It's on top of Coughlin, the defenseman, but he jars it loose.
Gensel skates to the outside. Letang dusts it off. He's a double tip by Crosby. Loose. He scores. Crosby. He took the cross check and he says, take that. 1-0 Pittsburgh.
It's a great job for the Penguins. And they just get the puck to the net. Bodies to the net, puck to the net. Sid with the first redirect. Ronta can't find it. Raquel's there. He whacks the pads. Raquel did a pretty good job whacking the pads of Ronta. They'll take a look at that, that whack, but not enough.
I think it was a decoy, Bobby.
Decoy whack, just to throw Ronta off because he didn't know where it was, did he?
Well, he drew the penalty, and he scored the goal. And that's all the Penguins needed, a 5-on-4.
Carolina trying to respond. Calvin DeHaan with the shot, looking for the stick of Stasny, and it's in on the follow-up. And the Hurricanes have tied the game up just like that. Martin Natchez, it's 1-1.
You know, he didn't get the rim coming around, too hot to handle, and they win a board battle D-to-D, and these guys have been kind of doing this all game, right? They get it to the up top and throw pucks through. It's been hitting bodies. They haven't been able to get much through. This one doesn't hit anything off the end boards, and that lively bounce on the perfect angle just lands on a tee for Natchez, the wrong guy.
Faceoff win, Carolina shot, score! Dalen Chatfield from the blue line. If it wasn't tipped, it's his first National Hockey League goal, and Carolina, just like that, has a 2-1 lead.
I think it's his. So now we're looking at the finer points of the game. Face-offs, where you're trying to make a difference. That shift after a goal, where the Canes were able to score, the Penguins weren't able to shut them down. A sign of a good hockey team is what Carolina just did. They bounced back quickly, and then another one off a face-off, and they had the lead.
Drew O'Connor still in the penalty box for another 32 seconds, fresh 20 minutes on the clock. Penguins putting their PK streak to the test once again. They've killed 14 in a row. 5 of 5 in the season series against Carolina. Bobby talked about the discipline. These are 2 of the 5 most disciplined teams in the NHL. Staal joined by Jesper Foss. Jordan Staal to the middle. Coughlin with the chance off the post on the follow-up. Couldn't slam on the rebound.
That was an interesting sequence, right? Stuck on the ice even after the power play expired. And they had 3 defense on the ice. Riedel was out there.
In front, Natchez, the chance denied by Jari. An incredible save. Martin Natchez can't believe it. Jari slams the door. Handled by Natchez. Natchez 4 power play goals on the year. Brent Burns. Burns, Teravainen, and drives. Hit by Nace and stopped by Jari. Penguins able to clear. For Dumoulin, can he clear off the body? He's going to skate it forward by Brock McGinn. McGinn's going to be joined by Beluger. Beluger speeding up by, shot by McGinn off the post. And the first player on the puck is Dumoulin. Dumoulin off the stick of Kotkaniemi, lands for Teddy Beluger. Beluger maneuvers in, against Jarvis, got the shot off, run to the save, the rebound, score, score, and it is Brock McGinn. And it is shorthanded, we're tied up at 2.
And as they continued up the ice, it was just a ton of passion. First by Kluger, and then by McGinn, and yes.
But he can move, and he's in your face. He plays hard.
Well, if you want to make a name for yourself, go up against 87.
Fitting way to start the third period. An icing call is a lot closer than some of the earlier ones. We've had a bunch. Carter, from behind, lost the handle. Root is there to help him out. But it's to Nason. Good tip pass. Overstep on is robbed by Jari.
Beautiful pass, wasn't it? Wow, that was something.
Jeff Carter up in the air, skipping puck. After it is Zucker. Slavin to beat. He protects it. Zucker, nice move. Got the shot off.
Minute 28 into this shift. Got that chance.
Shoves it forward. Steered out by Nason. Approaching 9 minutes to go. Third period. Kotkaniemi a chance. He fires Jari. Slams the door.
Then a quick turnover, and Jari has to come out and challenge. Big save by Jari.
That's Brent Burns. Tangled up with Zucker. Kick free to the middle. Charging forward is Rust. Ross into Hurricanes ice. Ross faking, cutting to the net. Hey, he scores! Brian Ross! The Rusty Razor! His move, 3-2!
No poke check. There's the kick out of the corner. Rust, the speed, the great hands, and no poke check at all by Ronta. Wow, he's just frozen. And that is stick handling in a phone booth right there. Great stuff.
Got a couple of quick ones after Crosby opened the scoring tonight.
Jari's doing his thing, Mirza. He's doing it again.
Pence couldn't get it out. Pesci the shot. Jari there again.
Another save, point blank.
Ripped across to Slavin. Slavin tees it up. Dangle away from Malkin. Slap shot blocked again in front. Letang in a whole lot of pain. Still got the puck to the board. Malkin wrestling against Stassi. Slavin, man up. It's Spetsnik on the chance. Unbelievable play again from Chris Letang, giving it his all in the final 5 minutes.
Where you don't want to take it
the first
earlier.
One.
Yeah, and then he just, he just stayed with it.
He's off win Carolina. Coughlin with the shot. Sits in behind for Staal on the wraparound. He scores. Jordan Staal has tied the game. He scores against the Penguins again. 3-3.
The offensive zone all game long. And there it is, just a quick win by Staal and a little bump out to the D. And then it's the size of boxing out Bluger down low here. He uses his body to shield in the net. And then that reach, a little help from Dumoulin as he tries to shut down that near side post. But
Pettersson content to hang on behind Jari, and that is going to do it for the third period. Should have an exhilarating overtime. The Pens and the Canes going to OT for the second time this season. Malkin against Staal. Start us off. Staal won it, immediately heads off. Hurricanes with the early possession.
Showed you how important the faceoff win was. Puck possession.
Racing up ice is Slavin, locates Burns, pass over, and in front, score! It's Slavin! They went the full 200 feet, 23 seconds into overtime, and the Hurricanes prevail 4-3, the final score.
That is really close.
Wow. Burns, the back edge of his blade was just on the plane, the backside of that blue line, guys.
Yeah, that was really, might have been his shot blockers that were onside.
Wow, great hands. That's a defenseman to make that move in tight quarters. That's an incredible move by Slavin. He's going at full speed there, Mirzi, for him to be able to take that pass and turn it that quickly. That is beautiful, handsy stuff.